correct? So we have seen how does cell wall is and how is cell membrane, and now we are into a topic that is how is the transportation of, or I could say movement of particles done in and out of the cell, right? And we have discussed that there are two basic types of transport. One is an active transport and second one is passive transport. When we say about active transport, it includes spending energy. And when I say it's passive transport, it is without spending energy, right? So in passive transport, we have again two bifurcations. One is diffusion and second one is osmosis. For diffusion, a very good example of how does a watercolor quickly dissolves in water was told to you. Just the similar way, small molecules like oxygen and carbon dioxide will enter and exit from the cell without using any energy from the cell. Now, let's move on to osmosis. We've also been halfway to learn osmosis and we've understood what is osmosis, but not completely yet. So in an experiment of understanding osmosis, we have taken two glass, we've added 2 and 10 spoons of sugar and made it a sugar solution. We've seen through the density or the concentration of particles. And now in an empty beaker, after creating a partition in between, we have added this 2 solutions on both the side. Correct? And the question was asked to you that which side's molecule will go which end, right? I hope I'm audible to all of you. Okay. Before we proceed ahead, one thing that if you need to ask anything or any doubts, please ping from where you are able to listen to me, from the account from where I'm audible. Okay. Now, to answer this specific question, one more question was asked to you that if you have 2 bogies of local train in front of you, then which bogie will you prefer, correct? And students answered, we will prefer the emptied ones. So can I say, if we, even as humans, are preferring a area which has got more space, don't you think even molecules will prefer the same? Yes. Okay, so with this specific question, even students answered that they would prefer an empty bogey. That means if we as humans can prefer space, why not molecules? So the answer for the previously asked questions, that will molecules travel from right to left or left to right? What will be the answer? From which place the molecules will migrate, from right to left or left to right? Correct, from right to left. And tell me, if we start understanding, or if I start putting osmosis into words, can I say it is movement of particle from higher concentration to lower concentration through a semi-permeable membrane? Is everybody with me on the same page? Understanding? Nothing bouncer so as? Okay. Now under osmosis, let's just read it once. This was the last slide which we had been through. So it is movement of solvent molecules through a selectively permeable membrane. Okay, there's some network issue. Okay, students at your end have network issue. Okay, no problem. So it's movement of solvent molecules through a selectively permeable membrane from a region of higher concentration to lower concentration until the concentrations become equal on either side of the membrane. Have you guys written this? Okay. Now moving on to the next slide, which is, let's understand a little thing more about osmosis. Now before we are understanding osmosis little into more depth, there are a few words which I want you to understand first. Let's understand them one by one. So hypo is the word whose meaning is less. So hypo ka meaning is less. If I say hyper, it means more than the required amount. Hypo is less, hyper is more. All right, I hope no confusion. Next word is iso. Iso means same. Okay, I'm repeating it once again. I also want you at your place to repeat this. Hypo is less, hyper is more, and iso is same. Now, have you heard about the word called as tonic? If you take any cough syrup or something, that liquid medicine is also called as tonic. Right? So tonic is nothing but a solution which can have a specific effect. So here comes the word tonic, which means nothing but solution. And I want you to write these four words immediately into your book. These are the keywords which we have to remember for a very long time. Hypo is less, hyper is more, iso is same, and tonic means solution. Done? Okay, cool. Now, what is it? These are raisins. I hope everybody is familiar with them. Okay, we are going to do a small experiment by using these raisins. But tell me, do you know raisins are made up of which specific fruit? How are raisins made? Correct. They are made up of grapes. Are grapes sweeter in taste a little bit? Are grapes sweeter in taste? Yes. If grapes are sweeter in its taste, can I say they have some amount of sugar content inside them? Okay, very good. So now we know that raisins have some amount of sugar content inside them. Okay. Now what if we put these raisins inside water? Will there be any change? If we put raisins in water, will there be any change? Have you ever done the practice of adding any pulses to the water? Right? Let it be matki, moong, or any legume. Does it remain same? No. What happens? What happens? They sprout. Will they directly start sprouting? The moment you put it in water? No. What happens to them? First, the dormancy breaks for the seeds and they swell up a bit. Now, why is the swelling of seed taking place? Because these seeds absorb water. So if seeds can absorb water, can even grape absorb water? Yes. And if the grape is going to absorb water, can I say they will also swell up a bit and they will become turgid? And they would look something like this. Now, after looking also in the second picture, can I say that there is difference between what the raisins were earlier and now as what they are looking? Now, what has happened in the experiment? What has happened? Raisins were added to the water. Water was absorbed by the raisins. And if water is getting absorbed by the raisin, can I say something is entering the cells of the raisins? Yes. Can I say, is it again a type of osmosis? But here, water is entering inside the cell. If it is entering, can I call it as endosmosis? The spelling will be E-N-D-O-S-M-O-S-I-S. Don't worry, I'll give you the spelling once again on the next slide. Don't worry. Right? So this phenomena is that how raisins will absorb water and endosmosis will take place. Now, what we are going to do is you will carefully listen to my questions and you will answer it. Ready? Ready, students? Okay. Now, let's assume that the sugar content of the raisin is 50, some 50 units. Okay? And you are adding this raisin into a sugar solution. Listen to me. You are adding this raisin into a sugar solution whose sugar content is 25. ठीक है, तो अभी मुझे बताइए कि शुगर रेजिन में ज्यादा है या फिर सॉल्यूशन में ज्यादा है? मोर अमाउंट ऑफ शुगर इज प्रेजेंट इन रेजिन और इन द वाटर? इन द रेजिन, राइट? एंड एज पर ऑस्मोसिस, कैन आई से दैट मूवमेंट ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स विल टेक प्लेस फ्रॉम हायर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन टू लोअर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन? इन दिस केस the raisin molecules will go outside of the raisin, right? Will still the raisin swell up or it will shrink? It will shrink. Pakka? Okay, you all are correct. It won't swell, it will shrink. Now, this is the case which is called as hypotonic solution. Okay? Second image, I have isotonic solution. That means water content inside the raisin and outside the raisin is same. Isiliye, water will neither enter the cell nor it will exit the cells. It will remain as it is, same. In case of hypertonic solution, as we just discussed, the raisins are going to get shrinked. Why? Because water content will move outside. Now, if the three images are clear to you, let us quickly come to understand what are these three types of solution. Let's go with the first one, isotonic solution. The most easiest ones. Okay, here medium outside and inside the cell has same proportion of water. Therefore, water doesn't go out nor it comes in. Okay, let's refer to the second image here. It will remain as it is. Now let's understand what is hypotonic solution. Here, the cell has less water than the outside medium. So if the cell is deficit of water, will it absorb water from the surrounding? Yes. And if the cell is going to absorb water from the surrounding, don't you think it is going to increase in its size by absorbing water and it will swell up? Understand, here we are mentioning about entering of something. Therefore, this is also called as endosmosis. Now the spelling is given very clearly on your screen. Okay? And the diagram for hypotonic is as you can see on the screen. Now let's come to hypertonic. Now looking at the diagram, tell me water will be more in which medium? Inside the raisin or outside the raisin? I am asking you for hypertonic. Huh? The water medium will be more in the cell or outside of the cell? Understand, जहां पे भी water medium कम है उसमें water जाएगा. So if the medium is more in raisin, that means it has to be less in the outside medium. Therefore, water will leave the raisin and it will go outside. Now read the sentence carefully. The cell has more water than the outside medium, so water comes out of the cell. Okay, I want you to write these three sentences quickly. Yes, you need to write it down. I am giving you just 1 minute to write these three sentences, and you'll be writing them under the title as osmosis. Okay, I'll explain you the hypertonic solution once again. Listen to me very carefully. यहाँ पे raisins जो है ना उनमें water content ज्यादा है, ठीक है? Then the water in which they are kept. So these are the raisins which have lots of water inside them, but outside the raisins the water amount is less. So in such case, tell me, will water still enter the raisin or it will leave the raisin? Hello? Am I audible? Clearly? Okay. My question was, if the raisins have more water, still, and in this, then the surrounding area in which the raisins are kept, still water will enter the raisins or it will exit from the raisins? Correct. It will leave from the raisins. Right? That is nothing but hypertonic solution. Because where is the water hypered? It is more inside the raisin, right? So solution inside the raisin is hypertonic. Are you getting it now? Okay, good. I hope everyone must have done with the writing part. Moving on to the next slide, where I am going to show you a video about how does cells leave inside the cell. Not leave, how do they stay in the cell? So we have completed with our cell membrane and we are beginning with the next cell, important cell organelle you can say, which is nothing but cytoplasm. Now cytoplasm is not specifically a cell organelle, but it is an important part of the cell. If you remember, cytoplasm includes everything inside the plasma membrane and outside the nuclear membrane. Okay, I am receiving things like my voice is not audible. Is it still problematic for most students? Then I can understand whether the network issue lies at my end or at students' end. Okay, so we are going to start with cytoplasm. If you remember very well, cytoplasm is everything inside cell membrane and outside nuclear membrane, that is outside nucleus. So it will also include various cell organelles and it will also include the liquid part, correct? Now here in this specific slide, I'm going to show you a very small video to just give you an idea that how all different cell organelles are staying nicely within a cell without dashing each other, without any traffic jam. And they'll be swimming very freely. So what are you able to see right now? Is the purple color nucleus? It has got pores. The nucleus is completely covered with endoplasmic reticulum. The red color things which you are able to see is nothing but a mitochondria, and other cell organelles are present, right? I know you won't be able to view the video with a, you know, very nice and smoother speed. It will be in breaks, but I hope you are getting an idea what will be the environment inside the cell, right? Those small dots are ribosomes. R-I-B-O-S-O-M-E-S. And ribosomes are produced by a very small part called as nucleolus, which resides inside the nucleus. I hope you remember, I taught you that day on a whiteboard. What is the name of the cell? This cell is a eukaryotic cell. Yeah, right now the video is paused. Okay, so let's begin with the characteristics of cytoplasm. Now, as we know that cytoplasm is that liquidish part, tell me what will be its characteristics one by one, since you know its background. Okay, I've received the first answer. It will be a place where all cell organelles are going to live. Yes. It will ensure that all essential things like proteins and everything will stay over there. Okay, so now let's look into cytoplasm one by one. Okay. So cytoplasm is nothing but a fluid between plasma membrane and nucleus, correct? It is a moving sticky substance, just like your jelly, but more fluidish. Okay, many cell organelles are suspended in cytoplasm, as you have just seen in the video. Now, let's talk about the liquid part. The part of cytoplasm other than the cell organelles is called as cytosol. So I also gave you a formula for this, that cytoplasm minus cell organelles is equal to cytosol, right? I hope you remember, cytoplasm is nothing but cell organelles plus cytosol. Or else if you want to understand what is cytosol, you have to do cytoplasm minus cell organelles. It is nothing but बाकी के न्यूक्लियस छोड़ के बाकी के सारे सेल ऑर्गेनेल्स एंड लिक्विड पार्ट विच इज नथिंग बट साइटोसोल. लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट. साइटोसोल स्टोर्स वाइटल सब्सटेंसेस लाइक अमाइनो एसिड्स, ग्लूकोज एंड विटामिंस. And one more important characteristic that how will you identify between an animal and between a plant cell is that jab kabhi bhi aap animal cell ko dekhoge to animal cell ka cytoplasm will be more granular. That means usme ribosome thode zyada rahenge as compared to a plant cell. A plant cell will be much more clearer to look under microscope. Getting it? Again, now I'm giving you 1 minute. I want you to copy these points quickly about cytoplasm. And then we will continue with the points. Is it done? Okay. Now let's move. You're still writing. Be quick, students. Okay, moving forward, let's understand the functions. Now you know that it acts as a platform for every cell organelle to stay within, for all of them to stay together harmoniously. So what are their important functions? Number one, they act as, that means cytoplasm act as a source of raw materials. Jis kisi bhi cell organelles ko kisi bhi cheez ki zarurat rahegi, cytoplasm will ensure ki sabke paas wo cheez पहुंच रही है टाइम पे. ओके, इट हेल्प्स इन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन एंड ऑल्सो एक्सचेंज ऑफ मटेरियल्स बिकॉज देयर विल बी लॉट ऑफ मैसेजेस व्हिच वन सेल ऑर्गेनेल हैव टू गिव इट टू अनदर सेल ऑर्गेनेल. तो वो पूरे पासिंग का काम भी करना है, वो भी साइटोप्लाज्म ही करेगा. सो दीज आर टू इंपॉर्टेंट फंक्शंस ऑफ साइटोप्लाज्म. गिव अ क्विक राइट टू इट. Okay, now if you are able to imagine a cell very nicely, we will see the hero of the cell is nucleus. Nucleus ko exact bahar chipka hua cell organelle is endoplasmic reticulum. Uske baad we have Golgi complex, then we have few vesicles, then lysosome around, and then plasma membrane. Correct? And it looks something like this in sequence. So let's understand the diagram from right side to left side. Moving on to right side, the entire orange color is nothing but your nucleus. Yellow color part is the liquid or fluid of nucleus to which we call as nucleoplasm. ठीक है? Nucleus के अंदर छोटा orange जो दिख रहा है, that is nothing but nucleolus. This nucleolus will be responsible for production of ribosomes. जो ribosomes इस nuclear pore से बाहर आएंगे, ठीक है? एंड दे विल गेट स्टिक टू एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिक्यूलम. फिर ये एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिक्यूलम में अच्छे से खेलेंगे zigzag, 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 just like a puzzle. And then finally, they will end up with this ending of ER called as smooth endoplasmic reticulum, the last pipeline. Iske baad, are you able to see such knob-like structures? Ye proteins and ribosomes pack ho jayenge and they will take an exit from ER. ER is endoplasmic reticulum. The moment they are taking an exit from endoplasmic reticulum, वो धीरे से जाके गोल्जी को चिपक जाएंगे. जैसे ही वो गोल्जी को जाके चिपक जाएंगे, गोल्जी विल टेक दोज वेसिकल्स इन विद इन देयर बॉडी एंड दे विल मॉडिफाई जो भी मिला है ईआर से. मॉडिफाई करने के बाद गोल्जी इसको जिसके पास भी भेजना है उसके पास भेजेगा. देयरफॉर दे विल बी ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज ट्रांसपोर्ट या फिर सीक्रेटरी वेसिकल्स. एंड जो कुछ भी मैसेज सेल के बाहर भेजना है वो गोल्जी के पीछे वाले साइड से निकल के सेल मेम्ब्रेन को फ्यूज होके, दैट इज प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन को फ्यूज होके सेल के बाहर वो मैसेज सेंड किया जाएगा. इज इट अंडरस्टूड? आई नो इट्स लिटिल कॉम्प्लिकेटेड बिकॉज एवरीथिंग इज वेरी न्यू टू यू राइट नाउ. यू जस्ट नीड टू रिमेम्बर द सीक्वेंस. डज न्यूक्लियस एक्ट लाइक द हेड? न्यूक्लियस के अंदर है न्यूक्लियोलस जो राइबोसोम्स बनाएगा. ये जाके एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम को चिपक जाएंगे. फिर zigzag zigzag लाइक एन इंटरनल रोड और हाईवे इट विल पास ऑन फ्रॉम वन पाइप टू अनदर पाइप. फाइनली इट विल रीच एट अ प्लेस कॉल्ड ए स्मूथ एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम. यहां से वो डिटैच हो जाएंगे. जैसे ही वो डिटैच हो जाएंगे इनटू अ स्मॉल बैग लाइक स्ट्रक्चर दे विल बी कॉल्ड एज ट्रांसपोर्ट वेसिकल. ये ट्रांसपोर्ट वेसिकल गपचुप जाके गोल्जी को चिपक जाएंगे. द मोमेंट दे गेट स्टक टू गोल्जी, गोल्जी विल मेक मॉडिफिकेशंस इन देम एंड सेंड टू द रिस्पेक्टिव सेल ऑर्गेनल्स जहां पे भी वो मैसेज भेजना है. जो भी मैसेज सेल के बाहर भेजना है वो गोल्जी के पीछे वाले साइड से, लाइक फ्रॉम द बैक एंड ऑफ द गोल्जी दे विल मूव. दे विल कम एंड फ्यूज विद द सेल मेम्ब्रेन ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन एंड द मैसेज विल बी सेंड आउटसाइड ऑफ द सेल. Is this understood or any doubts as far as the entire working to any student? Yes, no, don't worry. For each and every cell organelle, I will definitely show you a small video so that it becomes easier for you to understand if you try visualizing them. Okay, the next cell organelle which we will be starting in the next time will be nucleus. Remember, nucleus is the hero cell. Okay, cool. Already we are done with the time, so I'm stopping the lecture right now and right here so that next time we come we'll continue with the nucleus. For any doubts, please ping on the chat box. For others, thank you very much.